talk about the ABCs, and we can learn about the 1, 2, 3s. But it's all about you and me having fun together. And we can talk about your family, and we can learn anything. But it's all about you and me having fun together. Welcome, everybody. We got the Shannons in the chat. Hello. Thanks for joining us here. My name is Ben. This is Cole. It is time for another RME Music Lab. We have a fun episode today. Cole informed me yesterday, actually, that it was Bono's birthday. Yesterday was Blue Monday, so we put this off so we could learn the songs, get a better grasp on them here, figure out all the appropriate guitar parts, but we're gonna do U2uesday today and play some awesome U2 hits. But before we get to that here, I see, we got my dad out there. I know he's excited about U2uesday. Before we get to that here, I got some blues lyrics here. I wanna share with you, we've been doing in normal times, we get in this room actually here, we do our River Currents tours, and fifth graders from all around the Quad Cities come here. They write their own blues lyrics and they bring them, and on top of talking about the history of American roots music and the history of the blues and all that kind of stuff, we perform their blues lyrics for them. So it's pretty cool. For a lot of them, it's the first time that they've heard something they've written performed on a stage. And so obviously, right now we can't get everybody in this room. We can't fill this room up with 100 fifth graders, and you know, it's just not really a safe thing to do right now. So we've been doing Zoom sessions for the blues lyrics. We've been doing pre-recorded stuff, all kinds of things like that. And so I was actually just doing some here for a group of kids over at Eisenhower. And I just wanted to share with all of you a couple of their blues lyrics for our blues lyrics here today on Music Lab. They also came up with their own blues singer names to go with these lyrics, and they're incredible. So that's how I will be introducing them here. Let's do a key of E thing, just kind of a classic blues, right? So this one's called The Turtle Blues by Blind Gumbo McGee. My pet turtle really likes to fly away. My pet turtle really likes to fly away. He likes to fly up so high in the sky and sway. So, then this other one here, we got the Best Friend Blues. And let me tell you, this one is not going to go where you think it goes. The Best Friend Blues by Red Dog McGee. And this one goes like this. My friend was at my house and clogged the toilet. My friend was at my house and clogged the toilet. Blouse is not white anymore, so I gave her a mullet. Let's do one more of those here for y'all. I think these kids come up with the funniest blues lyrics. I'm always amazed by them. And you know, I think a good rule of thumb here, especially with these kids, that you know, this is probably the first song they've ever written. A lot of times they don't know what to write about, so then we get songs like this that are written by Brown Dupree. It goes like this. I don't know what to write about. I have a blank page. Well, I don't know what to write about. I have a blank page. It's due Friday and my third line is trash. I'm in such a rage. I wanted to play a lead part there because Cole's going to get a lot of the fun guitar parts here today. We're going to do U2uesday. Like I said earlier, it was Bono's birthday yesterday, so happy birthday to him. Definitely one of the iconic voices in rock and roll. But U2 also has, I feel like Bono's the name probably a lot of people know, but there are some incredible musicians in U2. Including we got Adam Clayton on the bass and Larry Mullen Jr. on the drums and The Edge on guitar. I think especially in a lot of these U2 songs, a lot of times we focus on The Edge and Bono because, you know, the lyrics are great, the singing's great, the guitar playing is super iconic and fun. But man, these songs are held down by the rhythm section. So many of them, it's all the rhythm section with all this extra stuff going on top. So we ought to make sure that we shout out them. We got Vic checking in here, U2 fanboy checking in as well. All right. And of course we have Kim Shoulda checking in. So we're going to kick things off here, and we're going to play the first three songs off of U2's giant mega album, The Joshua Tree. It's like, I think this is the first time we've done this on Music Lab where we've just like, we're just going to play the beginning of the album for you here.
All the way through.
So, I will now throw this to Cole and say, take it away.
All right.
Because the delay on this is very important, so it needs to be in time with the guitar.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you. Where the Streets Have No Names. Nice job on the edge guitar part there. There, Cole. All right. Next one up here. Oh, wait. I forgot. Oh, hang on. There we go. Well, before we do this last one here off Joshua Tree, let's make sure we talk a little bit about U2 for some of you that may not be familiar with them, especially the younger members of our audience. U2 is a band from, they were formed in Dublin, Ireland, back in 1976. They all went to high school together. That was how they got started, just a group of friends getting together and making a whole bunch of noise. That's kind of the best way to start a band right there. Since then, they have had 14 studio albums and are one of the best-selling music artists of all time. They've sold 170 million records worldwide, and they've won 22 Grammys. That's more than any other band. They're in rare company right there. Rock and Roll Hall of Fame in 2005, the first year that they were eligible. They, a number of awards outside of Grammys, including awards from Amnesty International, And yeah, that's one of the things too, when we talk about U2, they started out as they were very heavily influenced by the punk rock that was going on there in the UK. When we talk about like bands like The Clash and stuff like that. So early on and throughout their entire career, their music had a big element of activism to it. You know, there's a lot of songs about the environment and about equal rights and all sorts of things like that. And Bono in particular is known for being very philanthropic. There's, how about that for a fun word right there? There's your good definition. There, you can look that one up. I demand the entire Octon Baby album, maybe for a future music lab. That's gonna take a little more practice, I think. So, let's see here. How are we doing on time? We're doing okay. I think we're gonna be able to get all the songs I wanna play in here. But we're gonna start, we got one more song from Joshua Tree, which is an incredible album. Really like one of the all-time bests right here. I appreciate this one because Bono sings in a baritone to start it off. Which really helps somebody like me with a lower voice.
Is this the riff one or is that the... This isn't it, right?
What?
This isn't the riff one, this is...
Oh, no. Thank you. All right. You know, let's take a second here and talk about, while I figure out what I did with those. Oh, here we go. So we mentioned the edge earlier in our show here. I want to talk about what's going on here with your guitar, Cole. So you wanna explain what you got here? What's making all these kind of ambient guitar noises that you got going on here?
Yeah, so the two most important guitar effects that the Edge usually uses are delay and reverb.
Mm-hmm.
And so the delay, it repeats the note like a couple times, but then it dies out. So this is what I used on the very first song we played. So I'm only plucking it once.
Yeah,
you're
but doing
the note repeats.
Yeah. But the effect is causing this bounce back sound on it.
Yeah, it's kind of like a ping pong.
Yeah.
Like, you know, and the sound is delayed, so it keeps going, and it has its own feedback.
So it gives this really cool sound where it sounds like you're playing a lot more than you actually are.
Yeah.
It's a really cool effect. You know, a lot of people, I feel like, you know, sometimes people want to say in a negative way that they think the Edge plays guitar pedals more than he plays guitar. I don't really think that's a negative thing. And in fact, I think that that's been hugely influential on guitar players today, where I think there's a lot of guitar players that are out there right now as some of like the top guitar players that do create a lot of ambient type noises, and it's using the guitar in a whole different way than, you know, say like Leo Fender ever thought it would be used.
Yeah.
You know, so I think it's really like, it's a really a creative way of playing guitar, and really it's one of those sounds. I mean, we talk about guitar players where when you hear them, you immediately know who they are. You know, and there's like people like Jimi Hendrix, where it's like you hear him play and you immediately know it's Jimi Hendrix. I feel like the Edge is one of those guys,
yep,
where if you hear a guitar part, you immediately like, oh yeah, that's, even if you don't know the Edge, you know U2, and you're like, that sounds like U2. It's a very iconic sound, and it's really, I mean, I think they're probably the only band that really has that sound, you know?
Yep.
And obviously, you know, a guy like the Edge is heavily influential on a person like, you know, Tom Morello from Rage Against the Machine or Audioslave, who it's all about the effects and creating sounds with the guitar that a guitar is not supposed to make.
Yep.
So it's pretty cool. All right, so we're gonna do one more song here for you. This is an earlier U2 song, the U2 that I really like, where they're still kind of punky. And we're gonna do this one here, and I think that's probably all we're gonna have time for. So let's... One, two, three, four. I was on the outside when you said you needed me. I was looking at myself, I was blind, I could not see. Tries hard to be a man. His mother takes him by the hand. He stops to think, he starts to cry. Oh, why? If you walk away, walk away, I walk away, walk away. Yeah, I will follow. If you walk away, walk away, I walk away, walk away. Yeah, I will follow. On the inside when they pulled the four walls down, I was looking through the window, I was lost, I am found. And I walk away, walk away, I walk away, walk away. Yeah, I will follow. If you walk away, walk away, I walk away, walk away. Yeah, I will follow, I will follow. Thank you.
follow. If you walk away, walk away, I walk away, walk away, and I will follow. I will follow, yeah, and I will follow.
You don't really need much more than two chords right there. All right, well, I think that's all we have time today for. That's the end of that sentence. But thank you, everybody, who joined us and watched along. I hope you had as much fun as we did. I know this has been a fun show to put together, to learn the songs, to play here. You too. Go listen to you too.
Never have too much delay.
No, right? Yeah. And, yeah, if you're a guitar player, go get a delay pedal and learn some of these songs, because they're super fun. I mean, even just like... That's a super fun guitar part. It's not that hard, but it is super fun. That's like, it doesn't need to be complicated. All right. Well, big thank you to Mediacom. They take our show here and they put it on their channel. I'm sure some of you are watching it that way right now. You can also watch along live with us 3:30 Central Standard Time on the River Music Experience Facebook page. We record it live every weekday, so you can join us. I'm glad the internet actually worked for today. You know, we had a fun show, and I'm really glad that we were able to do it live for all you folks here, have people in the chat. It was a lot of fun. And yeah, let's send them on our way here. Let's do Walk Away, but with the... Like, just... Yeah. You can talk about the ABCs. You can learn about the 1, 2, 3s. It's all about you and me having fun together. Talk about your family. We can turn to anything. It's all about you and me having fun together. Having fun together. Having fun together. Having fun together. We'll see you all tomorrow for another episode. Until then, have a great rest of your day.
See ya.
Thanks for watching. If you want to help support River Music Experience and other programs like Music Lab, visit rivermusicexperience.org/donate.